Get ready to match the stars. Soupy Sales. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Riley. Madeline Rue. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match, Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reagan.
Betty Olson and friends. They're a lively bunch, aren't they? All right, I'm going to keep you agitated all day. That's enough. You can stop now. I would like to make an announcement, brief announcement. There are two male celebrities on the panel who are not wearing socks.
I know one.
That is all I'll say. And I welcome you and ask you to just give a brisk round of applause. Gotcha, you rascal.
Gotcha.
That's right. Now let's say hello to our two players over here, Brenda Maher and Mary Rickabosh. How are you?
How much money do you want?
$5,600.
Really? What are you going to do with that money?
Oh, I don't know. I can find something.
You can find something to do with that money. $5,600. That'll warm the cockles of your heart, won't it, Mary Rickabosh?
If I win it, yeah.
You've had your first round question, and it was a little difficult, wasn't it? Well, don't worry. They get harder as it goes along. No, your question will be long in a moment or so, but right now we want to do a little business with you. Pay attention. Ready to carry on. Push the button and reveal the other question. Brenda, this is all yours. Listen carefully. Ugly Edna is so ugly, she pays... I'll tell you how. You don't have to ask, I'll tell you. She pays people just to blank her. Ugly Edna is so ugly, she pays people just to blank her. All right.
So ugly.
Ugly Edna is so ugly, she pays people just to blank her.
The old repeating question,
Dad. Yes, that's what it is. That's right. Everybody down in the lower tier is ready. Okay. Charles, you're delaying the game. Perfect. Very good.
Isn't that amazing?
That's very good.
I'm
all right.
Beginning to think
come
like
over
I'm
here
very
to bring Mar. Ugly Edna is so ugly, she pays people just to blank her.
Look at her?
Just to look at her. She says Ugly Edna is so ugly, she pays people to just look at her.
I know that because I got $5. Because I
you got $5 to look at her. Okay. That's one for her.
You know what I say? You brung her, you look at her.
Okay. That's two for you, Brenda. Now.
That's very good. I went a whole other way.
You did.
Look at her.
Oh. That is a whole other way. Ugly Ed is so ugly, she pays people just to look at her.
Yeah, well, I really went the other way. I figured you had to look at her, but you'd have to pay her to kiss her.
Oh, yeah, I see. You'd have to pay to kiss.
Yeah.
What did you say?
I'll kiss her.
Kiss. Three looks, two kisses so far. What do you got?
If you kept one eye closed, you only got $250.
Look at her. That's four for you. Isn't that unusual? First round questions are a little tough. Now, Mary, you may have A or B.
Yeah, I'll stay with B.
B. Okay, everybody plays. When Dumb Donald put on the fake mustache, it really hurt because he couldn't find any glue, so he blanked it to his lip.
Couldn't find any glue.
Yeah.
Oh,
he put on the fake mustache, and it really hurt because he couldn't find any glue. Oh, when he couldn't find any glue, he blanked it to his lip.
Sure, and it
that
hurt too.
Oh, wouldn't that hurt? Oh, dear me, that would really hurt.
I believe I do have the definitive answer this time.
Yes.
Well, so do you.
Yeah.
Now, while we get...
Oh, all right, you got the hang of it. Here we go. Mary. When Dumb Donald put on the fake mustache, it really hurt because he couldn't find any glue. So he blanked it to his lip.
Sewed it.
He sewed it. Gee, you know, that's not a bad answer. I didn't think of it. I was thinking of something else. What'd you think of?
I was thinking of this blonde.
No, come on.
No, I said nailed.
Nailed is what I had. He nailed it to his lip. Glue and nail. What do you say?
But I thought I had the definitive answer. I'm sorry, I said nailed also.
Nailed is a definitive answer, I think, there. All right, Mary, you got to match your remaining ones to stay in the game. She said sewed.
I'm sorry, Mary, you're nailed.
Nailed, sewed. Brenda wins the game. Whether everybody has stapled, nailed, and sewed. One sewed. Hello there. Hey, it's a pleasure to meet you, Mary. Now, we've got some gifts for you, and many thanks for being with us in Match Game 76. Mary Rickabosch, there she goes. Okay, while she's spinning off, we're going to spin these messages and then come back to you, okay? Here we go. Here we are. Brenda's won her second game. She has $5,700 now. She's going to try for another $5,000 or more. She could go over $10,000 if she has a little bit of luck and a lot of ESP. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, Brenda, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Head of blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the third one gets you $100. And who's going to help you over here?
Betty. Brett. Excuse me. Oh, I'm sorry. Brett. I was looking at
it's hard to tell us apart. I know.
This is before and this is after.
Brett.
What about head of state?
Head of state. Okay.
Richard.
Richard.
What Brett wears occasionally, a head of lettuce.
Head of lettuce.
And she looks right. Very, very nice.
Right.
Betty.
Oh, number three, let's see. Head of the house.
Yeah! Head of the house. Those are the three you got, Brenda. Head of the house, head of lettuce, and head of state. You want one of those, or have you got a better one?
No. I think I'll take head of the house.
Head of the house. That's one that
Betty
gave you. Head of the house. Do you agree with her?
I don't think so.
Some do and some don't. Well, we'll find out if you got a head of the house up there. Let us reveal the $100 response. Head of lettuce.
Oh, the prices are ridiculous.
Okay. We're looking for the head of the house. May we see the $250 number? Head of state.
Aren't you sorry now?
Yes. Yeah, I thought that was going to be a rotten answer, but you were right, Brett. You're always right.
Yeah, glazed look.
Yes. All right, here's the last chance for head of the house. Slide it, Earl. Hey, good for you. I tell you, I figured it'd be up there somewhere, but I really didn't expect it to be on top. Did you?
Nope.
No, none of us did.
I was desperate. The other two
this
have been
girl is a pretty good game player, isn't she?
Head of the family would have been better.
Head of the family,
true,
yeah. All right, you got another $500. You're up to $6,200. You're going to play for another $5,000 right now. Who do you want to try to match exactly?
Richard.
Okay, Richard. Swing around over here and face me. You ready, Richard?
Ready.
Ready. Aim. Here it is. Children's blank. Children's blank. Now he's finished. Children's blank. Get your ESP going over to Richard and see if he can come up with the same answer he's already written put on that card there. What do you say?
The only thing I can think of is Children's Workshop.
Children's Workshop. I tell you, you're doing better than I can. I can't think of a single answer. Some of these are hard. What are that? Toys. Yeah.
Children's Hour. Right.
Children's Hour.
No idea. Children's Hour is one.
Department.
Richard,
children's.
She said Children's Workshop.
I did Lillian Hellman's play Children's Hour.
Children's Hour. Yeah.
There were many, many.
Yeah, there are a lot of good choices here. You made a good one, he made a good one. You didn't get together, but you may next time. You got $6,200, you're going to meet another player. Let's welcome Eddie Franco. Okay, you can go on there now. Eddie, we welcome you.
Thank you.
Now we'll find out where Eddie's from and a little bit about him.
I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm an electrician.
You're an electrician?
Yes. Enjoy skiing, snow skiing, gambling.
Yeah.
Pretty girls.
Right? There's one.
No job if I ever heard one.
Right. Where do you ski, Eddie?
Up at Bryan Head up in Utah.
Uh-huh. Okay, good luck to you here. You ready?
Yes.
All right. All right, does a gambling man want A or B?
B, please.
B, why? Okay, he wants B. Why not, he said. When the three bears came home for dinner, Papa Bear said, Mama Bear, I'm not going to eat this stuff. Someone's been blanking in my porridge.
I'm not going to eat this what, sweet?
He says, Mama Bear, I'm not going to eat this stuff. Someone's been blanking in my porridge.
I got that one. Oh, go for it, sweetheart.
Why not? Okay.
Lyra wants to see it.
Oh, yes, of course. Listen, don't forget to watch.
Oh,
Madeline Rue on Executive Suite begins September 20th on CBS.
Yes.
Okay? Eddie Franco, are you ready? We're ready for you. When the three bears came home for dinner, Papa Bear said, hey, Mama Bear, I'm not going to eat this stuff. Someone's been blanking in my porridge.
Tinkling?
Really? I don't know what to say. What do you say?
I'd say the same thing.
You'd say the same thing. Well, I'm surprised at that little Goldilocks. What do you say?
I say somebody's at the door. I heard a tinkle.
Oh, you did. Yeah. Charles, hello, Charles.
I said stepping.
Somebody's been stepping in my porridge. Leave him alone.
Yeah. No, boo him, but get out of your system.
Why, you got a bad answer?
Yeah.
You got a rotten answer?
Uh-huh.
A really rotten answer. Let's see how rotten it is.
No.
Oh, that's terrible.
Oh,
what did she say?
Mama Bear, I'm not going to eat this stuff. Someone's been tinkling in my porridge, according to him. Why? Why? Go ahead.
That's a fairy story, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Tinkle, tinkle, little bear.
Little bear. Another one for Eddie. He's up to three now. No?
Couldn't quite bring myself. Someone's been sleeping in my porridge.
Sleeping in my porridge. What a mess that was. Hey, that's not bad, Eddie. Three in a first rounder is pretty good. Right, Brenda? Very good. Okay, we'll see how she does after we see about this. Thank you. Okay, we're ready to carry on. Are you ready to carry on, Brenda?
Yes.
It's all yours. He did well in his first round. Let's see how you do. Long John Silver says, aye. The first mate is wonderful. You all know that I have a peg leg. Do you know that? Well, for my birthday, he gave me a peg blank. The first mate. He's a wonderful man, my first mate is. For my birthday, he gave me a peg blank. Would you like to read it in your own native tongue?
Well, there are several choices, aren't there?
Well, first round questions, you know, are kind of wide open. You have to even go afield if you want. How are you? That's silk, right? Silk. Oh, silk is good. It's cotton?
It's cotton.
Oh, it's a silky cotton, isn't it? Ready up here. Okay, ready. Ready?
Would you like your question back?
Yes, I'd like my question back so I
there's
can read
your receipt.
It. Thank you very much. Here we go. All right, Brenda. Long John Silver says, aye, me first mate is wonderful. You all know that I have a peg leg. You know what a peg leg is, right?
Yes, but I don't know who Long John Silver is.
You don't know who Long John Silver is?
No, go on.
Long John Silver? He was a famous character in The Three Bears, wasn't he? Yeah.
That's going to hurt him deeply.
You
don't know who Long John Silver is?
You know Long? He was a pirate.
Okay.
A tough pirate.
Okay.
He says, you all know that I have a peg leg, a wooden leg. And he said, well, for my birthday, my first mate, a wonderful man, he gave me a peg blank.
Parrot?
A peg parrot.
Told you I didn't know who he was.
Well,
dynamite.
Yes, a peg parrot, she said. I don't expect it to come up here, but I got to go through the motions anyway. May I see yours?
You bet the Jewish parrot?
The Jewish parrot?
Said Polly wants a bagel.
Polly wants a bagel.
I said a peg shoe.
A peg shoe is a good response, Brett.
That's a good response? I think that's worse than peg parrot.
No, peg shoe is good.
Why?
Because it goes with a peg leg.
Oh, you're just trying to be nice to him because he's a guest. I said he gave her a peg... who was it?
Peg board is
peg
good.
Peg board.
That's another good one. Maybe a little better than Peg Shoe. What have you got?
I would hope.
Are we going uphill here or downhill?
That stinks, pegboard. Peg Shoe for a peg leg.
We got two shoes and one pegboard. Okay, Brenda is looking for a peg parrot, an unlikely possibility, but we must continue the search.
Right. This will match if the parrot was going out on a date.
He gave me a peg date.
I could.
You're getting weirder as the time goes on there.
I know.
Are you feeling well?
No, but you know, it's the everyday work.
I see. And you, Richard. For my birthday, he gave me a peg...
board.
Board is good. Right. And what do you say?
I guess I'm just an incurable romantic. Peg of my heart.
Peg of my heart.
Peg
turn left leg. House chances. So there we are. 3-0 score. End of round one. We go to round two and ask you to make a selection.
B again, please.
B. You are a gambler. Three people play. Charles plays, Madeline plays, and Betty plays.
The Three Stooges.
Right. Debbie said, driving around looking for guys is just like fishing. You gotta have bait. When I cruise around, I stick my blank out the window. That's what Debbie said. Driving around looking for guys is just like fishing. Gotta have bait. When I cruise around, I stick my blank out the window.
Excuse me.
Okay. Yes. Sure. Charles, you're
we
not writing. But you do play.
Why don't we just swap? I'll play and Charles can sit this one out and this
don't
way we will get
him.
Through. Distract him.
There we go. He's got it. He's finished. Okay. Eddie Franco. Here it is. Debbie said, driving around looking for guys is just like fishing. You gotta have bait. When I cruise around, I stick my blank out the window.
Derriere.
I see.
Moon River.
That's only in certain circumstances you could sing that. What do you say, Charles?
I said upper frontals.
Upper frontals. Okay. He's looking for the lower bottoms there. What do you say?
I said upper frontal too.
The boob. Well, you had two ways to go, and
you
went the other way. And hello, how are you?
It's Richard doesn't write, does it?
No, Richard doesn't write.
No.
I think Derriere is going a little far, and I would like to stay in the business. I said you stick your hooker out the window.
You stick your hooker.
Well, it's true.
Oh, yes, it's like the old vaudeville hook. So, isn't it funny? Round one was so great for you, and round two was not so great for you. Now, Brenda, you got a match 3-4. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Susan said, my date with Harvey was good and bad. The good part was he took me to a fancy restaurant. The bad part was he made me blank.
My date with who?
Harvey.
Oh, Harvey.
It was good and bad. Oh. The good part was he took me to a fancy restaurant. The bad part was he made me blank.
Honey, I think I got that one.
All right. Yes.
What?
Yes. Okay, put in the slot. Away we go. Brenda. Susan said, my date with Harvey was good and bad. The good part was, he took me to a fancy restaurant. The bad part was, he made me blank.
Pay.
According to the audience response, she came up with a winning answer.
Well, you can't let your fans down.
You
Sally
can't.
Rand once said that to me.
Yes.
And I said, pay.
All right, the score is now 3-1. She needs two more to tie. Brett?
My mother always said to me, lead a good, clean life. It's the woman who'll pay for it.
I see. Score is now 3-2. One more to tie. Charles?
I chose pay also.
Okay. Tie score. Brenda, one more, and you win the game. Madeline, show and tell.
Okay, pay the check.
Pay the check wins the game. We got pay. All the way across. Hey, Eddie, it was a pleasure to meet you.
It's a pleasure
always
being here.
Grand to meet an electrician from Las Vegas, Nevada. Good luck to you. Got a gift for you. So long, Eddie Franco. Natalie's spinning off. We'll spin these messages for you. Come back. See how she does. Now, we just have time to thank all of these beautiful people here for being with us and for making such a terrific contribution. What are you doing?
I'm playing cards.
Playing cards? The show is over. There's nothing else. The game is over. There's nothing else to...
I got a bad one.
Oh, you did get a bad one.
Yeah.
That's a joker.
That's the joker, yeah.
All right.
Say goodbye.
Listen, sign, say goodbye. Join us next time. That's Game 76. Goodbye.